Hey guys, today I'm riding in Basque country. I'm here with Balkar. He's taking me along a tour from Bilbao. Check it out, we're at the ocean, we got the cliffs, we got the mountains, we're gonna be riding up some very steep mountains of the Vuelta. I'm gonna be racing those Strava KOM times from the World Tour. Wish me luck. You wouldn't say that last night I landed in pouring rain with thunderstorms all around Bilbao in the dark. It was pretty hectic. Check this out. What's up guys? What's up cycling fanatics? Welcome to another episode of Cycling All Over Europe. Today I'm in Bilbao in Spain. I'm riding somebody's Elsa's friend's bike. We're going for a spin 100k into the mountains. I'm here with Balka, which is his nickname. Balka has a friend who borrowed his bike.
Yes, his name is Nacho.
Nacho borrowed his bike. Yeah. So I'm riding Nacho's bike. Nacho has never seen me before. Would you give your bike to a random guy that comes into town? Who does that? Cycling fanatics. Okay, go left.
Okay.
So you guys know we have to get out of the crazy part of the city first, but first stop will be a bike shop. I'll show you a little bit. I saw this little chip in the tire. Don't want to take the risk that this is gonna blow on a descent. So we're gonna just quickly swap the tire and then we're gonna go out for that ride. Was easy. It went really fast. At the moment, we're in between the trees, but I can already see some nice views. We're gonna go to the coast. We'll have mountains on the side, big cliffs on the other side, straight into the ocean. It's gonna be epic. Nothing is flat here in the Basque country, which is good. I need to be training on some climbs as I'm going to the Dolomites and not too very long from now. So every climb I can do is good. A little bit of the view, boom. We're gonna go around these two big mountains along the coast. Pretty awesome.
Like that, they build that power plant.
Nuclear, huh?
That nuclear power plant. There were a lot of protests.
They never used it.
They never used it. The uranium was never inside of the power plant.
I guess they put it right out the coast because they have a lot of water for cooling and stuff. Interesting stuff. The view actually was already really cool.
The power plant is that we don't have.
That's a nuclear power plant. Well, it's pretty obvious that there's nothing happening here, but
it never happens, nothing.
Nothing. Wasted money.
Yes.
Yeah, we don't see the view. Maybe on the other side. Huh! Talking about views.
Dragonstone, it's that.
Oh yeah?
That is Iceland or that peninsula.
You guys watch Game of Thrones? I don't watch it, I have heard of it, but apparently that's the Game of Thrones mountain thing.
Dragonstone.
Dragonstone.
Yes.
The Dragonstone. Nice, nice fact. Thank you. Talking about bikes, I'm riding the Orbea Orca today, which is a bike from Balker's friend. We have just installed a brand new front tire. Whatever, man. I don't know what to say about this bike. It's a carbon bike, 105 group tread. It rides fine. Is it Basque?
Yes.
Or Beja, it's from the Basque?
Basque brand, yes.
I didn't know that. You are on the Cannondale Super 6, yes, which is the predecessor of my 2021 Ultra bike, the Super 6 Evo. We all know this is a great bike. A rim brake version. I think this is a classic, man. This is a classic. Triple is old school, huh?
Yes.
I think you were strong enough to ride a double, but
yes, but it was like this, so.
It's actually nice in these mountains. I have a lot of people asking me questions about bikes and bringing bikes and how I set up my bike and that stuff. I think I'm a quick adapter. I just sit on the bike, put the seat in the correct height, and that's it. Next video will be answering all those questions on traveling and cycling and my job and how I set up my bikes and what food I eat and all that stuff. So stay tuned for that. Now we're gonna be riding along the coast, have some amazing views, fly up those mountains of the Vuelta. Have a great day. It's already a great day. It's freaking hot. Last night it was crazy. I flew, literally me, myself, I flew over these mountains to come in to Bilbao. This was, everything was covered in shit. I mean like clouds and rain and thunderstorms and all that kind of crap. Yes. Not good when you're flying an airplane. So we were zigzagging around those lightning strikes and showers and stuff. I was landing this plane in freaking rain. It was crazy. Next day, boom. That's how I like it. This is the top. That's the Dragonstone for whoever is. Hello. Where are you from?
Germany!
Germany!
Germany! And you are, where are you from?
Netherlands.
Netherlands.
How are you guys doing in the European football soccer game?
As usual, yeah, we start more or less at zero and then we win. As you know, maybe you remember it, 2-8.
I actually don't remember anything from soccer because I never watch it, because you know I only do cycling, so. But I wish all the Germans good luck in the European Games. Same to all the Basque people and the Dutch people. I actually do not care anything about soccer. This is a very nice view and we're gonna continue riding our bikes. Last little bit of the coast. We're gonna go back to Bilbao. See how fast I can be as a normal mortal human being against World Tour pros. Here we go. ...14 minutes. Average is 360. I'm still not at the top. I feel this is a really good climbing pace for me. Heartbeat is about 10 below my threshold. You know, I can keep this up for quite a long time. You know, a big ride like this with multiple climbs, a good way to go. Hola, amigo.
Hola.
¿Cómo está?
Comenzado.
¿Todo bien?
Todo bien.
It took me 18 minutes. It is tough conditions. Good training. Don't forget to eat and drink a lot when you ride your bike. I usually eat a lot of these things. I don't know what this is actually. It's like a raisin cinnamon roll in a flat form. Has a lot of carbs and sugar. It's good cycling food. When we get back to the hotel, I pull out my Strava to compare the data of myself and the World Tour. The absolute fastest people on this earth riding up these climbs. Yeah. Fresh mountain water. Now on the last climb, we kind of skipped the middle before last very steep climb, and now we're on the last one, roughly 15 minutes. It's very hot. We've already been riding for almost 4 hours with 2000 meters. Some parts have wind, like a headwind from the ocean, that's nice. Some parts are, like now it's in the forest, there's no wind and it's so hot. It's over 30 degrees right now. Very humid from that storm from last night. 16 minutes, 360 watts. Heart rate is still 10 beats below my threshold. That's actually pretty good after 4 hours of riding and in these very warm conditions. I'm gonna roll downhill to get some cooling and then pick up Bulgar. My tour guide is empty. All matches are burned, but we only have 10 kilometers to go. Almost at the top, for me the second time. And then it's downhill to the hotel. And I'm gonna share the Strava details with you guys. Also, I'm gonna be taking a shower, getting some food, and getting my uniform to fly back to Amsterdam. Can you say the name of that museum again?
Guggenheim.
Who?
Guggenheim.
Guggenheim. And it's a modern art museum.
Yes. The shape of the building, it's like a boat.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's like a boat in the river.
Yeah. Cool. It's almost 4.5 hours, 110 kilometers. Average power 217, normalized 280 because of the climb, so that's pretty good. 2400 meters. That's a lot.
Yes.
Now let's have a look at those Strava segments. It was somewhere at the end, huh?
Yes.
So that was almost 4 kilometers with average 7.6%. Pogacar in 2019, he did it in 10 and a half minutes. I'm down here at place 410, 15 minutes and 37. For me, it was 360 watts average over 15 and a half minutes. My heart rate was only 165, yes. Like maximum 170 in a little bit.
Yeah, you can do it faster.
So I can go faster, yes. That's for real. This was 4.2 kilometers with 8.3% gradient. Fast. Yeah, this one took me 18 minutes. That's what I timed during the climb. Average 357 and 160 beats per minute. So same, I didn't go full gas. I just wanted to get a steady pace, which I would be able to climb for a longer period of time. Yeah. But let's have a look. I have the 600th position. Who is the fastest? Oscar Gonzalez.
This is a pro from here, under Plazaola.
Okay. Anyway, they do it in 12 minutes, guys. 12 minutes. It takes me 18 minutes. Obviously, I didn't go full gas, but 3.5 kilometers, 7.7%. Also a nice climb. 153 beats per minute, so I went easy. Well, at 350 watts, so that's actually pretty low heart rate for me. So they go up with 20k an hour, I went up with 15k an hour, so that's a pretty big difference. Anyway, I want to say big thank you to Nacho, that's the guy who owns this bike, who's lending it out to me. I never saw him, he never saw me, but this is the only reason that I could go for a spin today in Bilbao, because there was no rental bike available. Another big thanks to my local tour guide today. And guys, stay tuned. Check up here for the other cycling around Europe videos. Gonna see you next time. See ya!